Hey, it's me, Polly. Tomorrow, an innocent man is gonna die. A man who has been on death row for nearly 20 years for a crime that another person was convicted of committing. Only the man who was convicted of committing this crime, this murder, was coerced by the police, and they have the tapes available now for us to see. This man was coerced by the police into implicating somebody else. Specifically, into implicating Richard Glossip. The man who actually murdered the victim got life without parole. And the man he fingered for the crime that he said was the mastermind, even though it doesn't make any sense, and there's no evidence of any kind. The man he pointed at and said he was in on it with me. He's gonna die tomorrow. He never had any problems with the law before that, and suddenly he's implicated in this murder, and he's found guilty, and he's sentenced to death. He's maintained his innocence all this time, and he sought help from the Innocence, I believe it was the Innocence Foundation, or the Innocence Project. He made a couple of mistakes in trying to protect his friend, who he thought was his friend at the time. And there have been all kinds of shenanigans and missing, burned up evidence, hidden evidence, withheld evidence, suppressed evidence on the part of the prosecution to hide the documents that would show that Richard Glossop likely had nothing to do with it. In fact, part of their coercion was to promise Justin Sneed, the actual killer, that if he implicated somebody, and specifically they pointed at Richard Glossop, who was only one of a number of people at that motel that night, if he implicated him, they would make sure he didn't get the death penalty. They gave him an incentive to implicate somebody else. And there have been witnesses who have come forward to say that they were incarcerated at one point or another with Justin Sneed, and they heard him exclaim, brag, boast, that he had done this crime alone, but that he had gotten this guy in trouble, that he had gotten away with it, and this guy was getting the death penalty, and he wasn't even involved. That makes me sick. It makes me so sad for this guy. Tomorrow at 3 p.m. His life is going to end. Because nobody would give him a fair shot. Two trials. And neither trial showed the videotape of the coerced confession. The jury didn't even know about it. They didn't find out until, I think, this year. And some of those people came forward and said, if we had known about this coerced confession, we would never have voted him guilty. We would never have found him guilty. I wouldn't have found him guilty. Only now have the defense attorneys, who are like ace defense attorneys, which were not available They were not available to Richard Glossop because he was poor. He was poor. He couldn't afford a good attorney. The attorney from his defense attorney from his first trial was disbarred afterward. There are two judges in the Oklahoma Criminal Court of Appeals who say we shouldn't put him to death. We don't know that he's guilty. There's not enough evidence. But unfortunately, they were overruled by the other three judges who said, we're going to put him to death now. We're not going to bother to wait. All his defense is waiting for, or asking for, is a little more time. I mean, they're trying to get the evidence together and the witnesses together. And talk about witnesses. Two witnesses came forward just recently saying he's innocent. We heard Justin Sneed say so. Justin Sneed was bragging about committing the crime alone and getting this guy into trouble. And after those witnesses came forward to the defense, for some reason, both of them got arrested. Both of them were harassed by the prosecution, trying to get them to change their story. They have been absolutely out for blood, doing everything they can. Every heinous, absolutely insanely horrible, evil thing they could do to get this man executed and get this case closed. It doesn't matter that there's no evidence. There's zero evidence against this man. And only the confession of the actual killer, whom they know killed him. That's all they've got on this guy. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because whatever their motivations are, they're political. They've got some other agenda, which has nothing to do with guilt or innocence. It has to do with how it affects their careers or how it affects the reputation of their office, as far as not humiliating themselves. I don't know. All I know is 300,000 American citizens signed the petition saying, please do not execute this man. We do not believe that he is guilty. That's more than 500,000 American citizens pleading with the Oklahoma State's Attorney's Office, please don't kill this man. There's no concrete evidence at all. No reasonable evidence to say that he did anything. I wrote him a letter. I wrote Richard Glossop a letter. I wrote a couple of write-ups trying to show how despicable the lack of logic is in this case. The only thing that they could use as evidence was Justin Sneed accusing him. Justin Sneed, who was a criminal. Justin Sneed, who was a murderer. But when these two witnesses come forward in defense of Richard Glossop, well, they don't have a good reputation because they were in prison. They're just criminals. You can't trust what they say. That's exactly their argument. If that's their argument, then they shouldn't trust what Justin Sneed says because he's just exactly the same. Only he had more invested in it. So he has a reason. He has a motivation to lie. These other two guys, all they have to gain out of it is being publicly, you know, tormented and put in the spotlight and ridiculed and questioned and not believed and then arrested and hassled by the prosecutor's office. They are out for blood. This is something that really bothers me. This is something that really bothers a lot of people. And it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how little evidence there was. They will convict anybody they can possibly convict, regardless of whether they had anything to do with a crime or not. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter to them. God be with Richard Glossop tomorrow as they strap him down to the table and they inject him with this stuff that may or may not actually suppress his pain. And they take his life when, by all accounts, by almost all accounts, it appears that he never took anybody else's life, that he wasn't even involved. But how do you prove you're not guilty? Believe me, I've spent my life trying to prove I'm not guilty for one thing or another. It's not possible. People believe what they want to believe. They punish and punish and punish because somehow that makes them feel better. I just felt like I had to say something about this. It's breaking my heart that this man has to suffer so that public officials can achieve whatever it is they want to achieve, and so that angry, hateful people can feel better for some reason that makes no sense to me. To me, Richard Glossop is America's sacrificial lamb, Oklahoma's sacrificial lamb, and America's sacrificial lamb. And he will be the next person who will eventually be exonerated, but it will be too late because he will already have been killed. They aren't willing to wait. They did 2 weeks ago. They gave him a 2-week stay, but they aren't willing to give him another one. In time for all of the evidence to come in. In time for these new lawyers who know what they're actually doing to be able to build a case and say, look, see, he's not guilty. He wasn't involved. He didn't do this.